It's Monday, 27th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. According to Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan, who held a review of relief and rehabilitation work on Sunday, 4,62,456 persons are still housed in almost 1,400 relief camps. Over 3 lakh houses have been cleaned till date. Apart from the physical challenge of clearing debris, cleaning flood-ravaged buildings, sanitation and medical care, the fiscal challenges of handling the post-flood reconstruction are growing, despite a massive inflow of aid to the Chief Minister's Distress Relief Fund. The centre has already released Rs 600 crore as advanced assistance, with another 562.45 crore given to the State Disaster Response Fund. The state government is preparing a memorandum for further assistance after Prime Minister Narendra Modi's assurance to Governor P. Sadasivam when the latter called him on Saturday. Mr. Vijayan also appealed to Keralites on television, both in the country and outside, to contribute a month's salary over 10 months for rehabilitation efforts. With educational institutions scheduled to open on August 29th after an advanced Onam vacation, cleaning 700 schools submerged by floodwaters poses a major challenge. Most of these schools have lost all their vital infrastructure. DMK Working President M.K. Stalin on Sunday filed his nomination papers for the post of party president, which fell vacant following the death of M. Karunanidhi. The election would be held when the General Council of the party meets on August 28th. Mr. Stalin's elevation as the DMK president is a foregone conclusion, as all the district secretaries have filed nominations on his behalf. Before filing his nomination papers, Mr. Stalin visited the memorials of party founder C.N. Annadurai, former Chief Minister Karunanidhi on the marina. He also sought the blessings of his mother, Dayalu Ammal, and DMK General Secretary K. Anbargan before filing the nomination papers. As party president, Mr. Stalin would preside over a memorial meeting for Karunanidhi on August 30th. Though BJP President Amit Shah had decided not to attend the meet, the party had reportedly deputed Union Minister Nitin Gadkari to attend the event. A completely green method developed by researchers from the University of Calicut, Kerala, can potentially do away with using water for sizing and desizing cotton and polyester yarn. The textile industry is highly water intensive and also one of the biggest water polluters. By using liquid and supercritical carbon dioxide instead of water and sucrose octoacetate in place of starch, a team of researchers led by Dr. Ravindran from the university's Department of Chemistry has made the sizing and desizing process eco-friendly. The results of the study were published in a journal, ACS Sustainable Chemistry and Engineering. The best part of this process is that it is zero pollution, zero waste, as both carbon dioxide and the sizing agent, which is modified cane sugar, can be recycled endlessly, says Dr. Ravindran. The researchers are next planning to scale up the process and are looking at setting up a pilot plant to test the green process. In a major breakthrough, the crime branch CID of the Tamil Nadu police has cracked the sensational train heist case in which Rs 5.75 crore cash assigned to the Reserve Bank of India was looted from a moving train a couple of years ago. The unprecedented train robbery occurred on the Salem-Chennai Express on the night of August 8, 2016, after a gang broke into the parcel van containing Rs 342 crore of soiled but usable currency and took away the money. It was technical evidence coupled with months of meticulous investigation that led the police to crack the train robbery and nail the gang in the case. Going by mobile phones that were active in the scene of the crime, investigators believe that the suspects broke open the roof of the coach to steal the cash as the train moved from Salem to Vilupuram. The users were from Madhya Pradesh and belonged to the same locality there. Inquiries revealed that the notorious gang was involved in several grave crimes in North India, a CBCID official said, adding that the gang operated on the roof and inside the coach all along. Since armed guards of the Salem City Police escorting the train inspected the parcel van at all scheduled stoppages. A life prisoner at the Mangaldoi District Jail in North Central Assam has topped the equivalent of Class 12 exams conducted by a state-based open university this year. Six of his fellow prisoners also came out with flying colors, making a success rate of 100% for the jail that has set a benchmark in the state for its efforts to reform the inmates. The Krishna Kanta Handiki State Open University conducts bachelor preparatory program, a course equivalent to Class 12 exams annually. This year's topper is 32-year-old Arup Jyoti Deka, serving a life term for murder. He secured 80.33% and letter marks 80 or more in economics, sociology, political science and English, a jail superintendent told reporters. Mr. Deka, in jail since 2012 after being convicted for murder, works as the jail's librarian besides compiling an Assamese monthly wall magazine titled Karalipi, meaning jail script in Assamese, for poems, essays and fiction penned by the prisoners. The literary endeavor, published as an annual magazine since 2016, has been praised by authors and poets in Assam for its quality content. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.72 rupees per litre and diesel for 69.23 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80.74 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.13 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 80.66 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.07 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 85.14 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.49 rupees per litre.